So now we will go to C 1.7. This is selection rules. In a two-level system, of course, there is no question. Spin half, there are only two levels. Then you will have only one transition possible. But if you have, let us say, I is equal to 1, there are three levels. So which are the allowed transitions? So for I is equal to 1, you have three levels. I is or M is equal to 1. M is equal to 0, well, this is minus 1, and M is equal to plus 1. So you can have a transition from here to here, here to here. Of course, these are equally spaced as we had calculated earlier. You can also have a transition from here to here. Is that possible? Is that allowed? So we call this, if these transitions we call as single quantum transitions, because it is delta M is plus minus 1, and this will be a double quantum transition because the delta M is plus minus 2. So are these, what are the transitions which are allowed? That's what is indicated by the selection rules. And we are now talking about RF-induced transitions. Okay, we are only talking about RF-induced. When we are talking about selection rules, we are currently talking about RF-induced transitions. There can be other transitions which are induced by the lattice. That will be talked later. But these are RF-induced transitions. How do we calculate this? This is dictated by the transition probability equation. You know the transition probability, P is given by, or is proportional to, is gamma square, H1 square, well, it comes afterwards, is M. And here you have the perturbation. Correct? So we have this, we are talking about a transition from state M to M prime or vice versa. And what is this H prime? This is the perturbation. H prime is the perturbation due to the So what is this? Okay, we can rewrite this in a little bit more explicit manner, and this is m dash. Okay, let's call it as right? So I'm just rewriting the modulus square as in these two terms. Now what is Hamiltonian perturbation? And the perturbation H prime So if you substitute and
what is
H1? H1 is your RF amplitude. Complex conjugate, so I will just put it here. I will take out this complex conjugate outside, then I will. And then if I take out the complex conjugate outside, then this and that will cancel. So you will have so this will be one. And then I will have this m dash, m mu dot h1, m. Now if I take the complex conjugate, I just turn them around, the ket and the bra will get interchanged. So I will have here m mu dot h1, m dash. This of course is a real quantity and therefore there is no question of complex conjugate here. So you just simply change this over. So in this situation, it appears that you have the transition from m dash to m. Here it is m to m dash. So it is symmetrical in m and m dash. Therefore, the transition probability is the same whether you do it this way or that way. Upward transition and downward transitions are equal. Transition rates are equal. Now what is mu dot h1? If my h1 is applied along the x-axis, okay? So it is only that component of mu which will survive. The other components will be zero, right? If h1 is applied along the x-axis. If h1 is along the y-axis, then the y component will survive and so on. So therefore assume that you apply h1 along the x-axis. Assume h1 is applied along the x-axis, then that will be equal to mu x h1. So then B will be m dash mu x h1 m mu x h1 m dash. Mu x is simply gamma I x. Okay, so I take out the gamma from there, so you get gamma square, and h1, h1, I also take it out, gamma square, h1 square. So then I will have inside here, m dash I x, m okay, so the IX operator, now these are operators now, incidentally. Okay, so we are going to operators, these are operators now. When you are operating all of this, when I say Hamiltonian operating, of course it means already it's implicit, these are operators.
Sir, how you have iterated?
So from here, mu X is gamma IX. So gamma H1, I take it out. Similarly, I take out from here gamma H1. Ix remains in both these places. Gamma h1 from here, gamma h1 from there gives the gamma square h1 square. And from the rules of the angular momentum, their matrix elements and things like that, it follows from properties of Ix operator or Iy operator, whichever operator. This matrix element is non-zero only if delta m is equal to plus minus 1. So delta m meaning m dash minus m or m minus m dash, the modulus of m dash minus m, if that is plus minus 1, then only this matrix element is zero, is non-zero. Otherwise it is zero. Therefore, it is only those transitions where delta m is plus minus 1 will be allowed. Therefore, you see in that spin 1 situation what we saw, 1, 0, minus 1, 1 to minus 1 transition will not be allowed. Only 1 to 0 and 0 to minus 1, these transitions will be allowed. So that is your selection rule. So only single quantum transitions will be allowed. Often we write the single quantums as SQTs. Okay?